नियतिकृतनियमरहितां प्लादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आददति भारतीकवेर्जयति. वि लुकिङ्ग् एट् वाक्यमात्रदोषाः. लास्ट् वीक् वि सा टिल् अनभिहितवाचित्वं, सोरि, अभवन्मतयोग्यत्वं. वि फिनिश् देट्. नौ वि हेव् टु लुक् इट् अनभिहितवाच्यत्वं. लेट् मी टेक् अप् द टेक्स्ट् आल्सो. ऐ फोगोट् टु डू देट्. या, सोरि. अवश्य वक्तव्यम् अनुक्तं यत्र यथा अप्राकृतस्य चरितातिशयैः च दृष्टैः अत्यद्भुतैः अपहृतस्य तथापि नास्ता कोप्येष वीरशिशुकाकृतिः अप्रमेयसौन्दर्यसारसमुदायमयः पदार्थः. सो द डेफिनेशन् दट् हि गिव्स् फार् अनभिहितवाचित्वम् इस् ओन्लि अवश्य वक्तव्यम् अनुक्तं यत्र. हि आल्सो गिव्स् अ लाट् आफ् एक्साम्पल्स् फार् देट्. So let's look at what the meaning of that dosha itself is. Anabhihita vachyam means anabhihitam cha tat vachyam yatra anabhihita vachyatva dosha. So anabhihitam, that which is not said. What is that which is not said? Vachyam. Vachyam, usually till now in Alankara Shastram we've seen vachaka shabdaha, vachyam, vachyaha is arthaha. The same way lakshanika shabdaha, lakshyarthaha, and vyanjaka shabdaha, vyangyarthaha. That's what we have seen. So here also you might think that vachyam means the artham, but it is not like that. Here vachya, vachyam, sarvatra idameva vachyam. If we say that, it means avashya vaktavyam ityartha. So avashyam, that which has to be said, is not said. वाचक शब्द अतिरिक्तं पदं यत् वक्तव्यम् अस्ति श्लोके तन्न उक्तं चेत् तत्र अनभिहितवाच्यत्वम्. वाट् इस् दट्? द्योतकम् अथवा विवक्षितं. सो दट् इस् वाट् हि मीन्स् बै वाच्यं. द्योतकं मीन्स् वेर् विच् इस् यूस्फुल् फार् गिविङ्ग् अस् द व्यङ्ग्यार्थ. इट् कुड् हव् बीन् इट् शुड् हव् बीन् सेड् बट् इट् इस् नाट् सेड्. दट् इस् युर् अनभिहितवाच्यं. सो यत्र वाचकपदात् अतिरिक्तं avashya vaktavyam padam, if that is not said, then it is anabhihita vachya. There are two ways in which this can happen. One is the difference by vachaka pada and vachya padam. Here the vachaka pada, if the vachaka pada is not said, it is called nyunapadatva dosham, whereas if the vachya padam is not said, then it is anabhihita vachya. There are two types of this: vibhakti nyunatvam and nipata nyunatvam. Even in Nipata Nyunatvam, he gives us two examples. One is in a samasa and the other is just without a samasa also. So let's look at the first one, which is Vibhakti Nyunatvam. That is this example that he has given. Aprakritasya charitatishayehi drishtehi adhyadbhutehi apagritasya tathapi na asta kopiyesha veerashishuka akritihi aprameya saundarya sara samudaya mayaha padartha. This is a shloka which occurs in Mahavira Charitam, written by Bhavuti. There, the moment Parashurama hears that Rama has broken the Shivadhanus, we've seen many shlokas in connection with that. So when he hears that, the first thing is he gets very angry. So he is not able to be quiet upon hearing that someone has broken his guru's bow. Shiva is Parashurama's guru. So he says, aprakritasya charitatishayehi atyadbhutaihi drishtaihi charitatishayehi mama apahritasya na astha. Even though I am attracted by the exceptional qualities of Rama, which is not seen in normal people, aprakritasya asya ramasya, or you can say aprakritasya is only ramasya. So ramasya prakritam is normal people, sadharana janaha. Aprakritaha asadharanaha, so atyadbhutaha. So the ramasya atyadbhutaihi drishtaihi charita atishayehi. Drishtaihi, I have seen or heard about his exceptional qualities, even though I have heard and I am attracted by those. Veera is, even if the other person is an enemy, is naturally attracted to the veeratvam that is there in another person. You appreciate the quality that is there. Otherwise, it is just krodham. Veera accompanies with an appreciation for the other person. Krodham is just blind rage. Aprakritasya atyadbhutaihi drishtaihi charita atishaihi aham apahritaha. Even though I am attracted by all of these qualities, tathapi na asta. So I'm just explaining it as how the vivakshitartham is. And then we will look at the construct of the shloka. So tathapi na asta. Even then, I don't have, so apakritaha api na astha mama, I'm not able to control myself, or I'm not, I can't believe this, na vishwasa nasti mama. Even though I've seen his display of skill, I still cannot believe what is happening, that he has broken Shiva's dhanus. So kopi eshaha, tatapi eshaf padarthaha. Padarthaha is not an object in front of me. It's like that. This person who is here, Kopi Eshaha, Veera Shishuka Akritihi. He has the form of a small, brave boy who is handsome. Aprameya Sondarya Saraha. So, aprameya means you incomprehensible. You cannot understand the beauty that is there in him. Tadrisha saundaryasya sara samudaya mayaha ayam shishu. Even then, I see that this person in front of me is extremely brave and handsome, and he's not to be such a form is not to be seen anywhere else. That is the shlokam here. So atra apahritaha asmi iti apahritatvasya vidihi vachyaha. Tathapi ityasya dvitiya vakya gatatvena eva upapattihi. Here, let's look at two parts. There are one part is we have to look at vibhakti nyunatvam. Here, apahritasya mama, in that way, what he is actually trying to say is charitaihi apahritaha asmi, or apahritaha aham. Tathapi na asta, or tathapi actually should go to the second line where he says tathapi eshav padarthaha mama purataha vidyate. I cannot deny the fact that Rama is in front of me showing such exceptional qualities. The first line he actually says, although I am attracted by his qualities, I am not able to believe it. Despite that fact that I am not able to believe it, he is standing in front of me. That's how the shloka's meaning goes. Okay, so charitaihi apahritaha asmi. I am attracted by his qualities. So there he has actually given apahritasya mama. In other words, you have to say apahritaha asmi. Asmi should be used in ahamarte vibhakti pratirupakam. In what is that shlokam before we have read that? Tvam asmi vachmi. I am here. Let me tell you. Believe in what I am saying. So don't go and open your mouth in front of this Vidvat Sabha. There is a shloka which we have read before in, I think, the second Ullasa or somewhere. Tvam asmi vachmi aham as. Tvam aham vachmi aham. Instead of aham, he uses asmi. Asmi is actually used in the meaning of aham. So tvam asmi vachmi means aham tvam vachmi. I am trying to tell you, I am telling you, so which means you can believe in me. That is the meaning that asmi gives us. Here also he says charitaihi apahritaha asmi, charitaihi apahritaha aham na astha. I am not able to control, able to believe this. Tathapi na astha bhavati. Tathapi should again come only to the second vakyam, in the sense tathapi ityasya dvitiya vakya gatatvena eva upapattihi. That is the meaning that is being, that we have to understand is charitaihi yadyapi apahritaha tathapi na asta, and tathapi kopi eshaha viraha asti. That's how it should be. Na asta is actually in the first half, right? 1 minute, let me look at that vyakhyanam. यद्यपि अपहृतः इति वाच्यम्, तत् च न उक्तम् इति अनभिहितवाच्यत्वम्। इफ् यु लुक् एट् दिस्, यद्यपि अपहृतः इति वाच्यं तत् न उक्तम्, सो दट् इस् द प्राब्लम् हियर्। यद्यपि तथापि, सो यद्यपि इस् नाट्, यद्यपि अपहृतः, अपहृतस्य मम न आस्था। सो वाट् हेपन्स् इस् ईवन् दो ऐ हेव् बीन् अट्राक्टेड् ऐ केनाट् बिलीव् इट्, दट् ईवन् दो गिव्स् ए फोर्स् आफ् व्यङ्ग्यम्, इट् काण्ट्रिब्यूट्स् टु इट्, सो इट् बिकम्स् अ द्योतकं देर् and that is not present here. That vachyartha, that should have definitely been present in the shloka, and that is not there. Okay, so next one is what is the next one? Nipata nyunatvam samasagatam and asamasagatam. Okay, we look at that here. Esho aham adritanaya mukhapadma janma achaluma.
இந்த யத்யபின்றத வந்து அத்யாஹர்த்தவ்யஹன்லாம் சொல்லக்கூடாது.
அந்த அத்யாஹர்த்தவ்யஹ யூ கேன், பட் தி திங் இஸ் இஃப் தி ஃபோர்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி மீனிங் இஸ் நாட் பிரசன்ட் தென் யூ கான்ட் சே அத்யாஹர்யம். அதுக்காக சொல்றார், ஐ எம் ஒன்லி ட்ரைங் டு ஜஸ்டிஃபை வாட் ஹி சேஸ். சி ஃபார் மீ கான்டெக்ஸ்ட் எடுத்துட்டோம்னா, பரசுராமா இஸ் யூ ஆர் லுக்கிங் அட் சம்மன் ஹூ இஸ் அனேபிள் டு பிலீவ் தி சிச்சுவேஷன் இன் ஃப்ரண்ட் ஆஃப் ஹிம். Would he think of all these grammatical mistakes here? Would he think of trying to provide the proper words there? I don't know. It conveys his attitude much better if there are some missing words. That is when you are caught up in that moment. Illaya enak appadi dhaan thonrathu, idu appadiye purinjin poidu, idla romba kelvi kekkada. Ha, seriya? ஏஷோஹம் அத்ரிதனயா முகபத்ம ஜன்மா பிராப்த சுராசுர மனோரத தூரவர்த்தி ஸ்வப்னே அனிருத்த கடனா அதிகத அபிரூப லக்ஷ்மீஃபலாம் அசுர ராஜசுதாம் விதாய அத்ர மனோரதானாமபி தூரவர்த்தி இத்தி அபி அர்த்தஹ வாச்யஹ. தி காண்டெக்ஸ்ட் ஹியர் இஸ் ஆக்சுவலி Usaharanam is the natakam from which it has been taken. I don't know who has written it and all. Aniruddha comes in the dreams of Usha. She sees Aniruddha. She is an Asura Raja Kanya. She sees Aniruddha in her dream. And he is actually Madana, Manmatha Avataram. Or Manmatha's son, he is. Pradyumna is Manmatha and Manmatha's son is Aniruddha. So he comes in person when Chitralekha is actually drawing his picture. Chitralekha is Usha's friend, the princess's friend. She is drawing the picture of Aniruddha based on what she has described about her dream. So after drawing that, this Aniruddha also comes in front and he says, Esho aham asmi, esho aham praptaha. I have arrived here. So he explains how he was born and how he has been the person of her dreams. So yeshaha aham adritanaya mukha padma janma, adritanaya mukha padma janma, adritanaya parvati, parvatyaha mukha padma janma, mukha padmam eva janma yasya saha. I have been born from Parvati's face. So Manmatha got his rebirth because of Parvati. So Parvatyaha Mukhat Jataha. So I, Mukha Padma Janma. So I am the son of Manmatha, or I am of the form of Manmatha. Adritanaya Mukha Padma Janma. I have been born out of the lotus face of Parvati. Sura Sura Manoratha Duravarti. I'm beyond the Duravarti, beyond the desires of both Sura and Asura, both the Devas and the Asuras. Sura Asura Manorathanam Duravarti Asmi. Swapne Aniruddha Ghatana Adhigata Abhirupa Lakshmi Phalam Asura Raja Sutam Vidaya. So Swapne, so Asura Raja Sutam, after making Usha, the daughter of the Asura king, a recipient of Aniruddha Ghatana Adhigata Abhirupa Lakshmi Phalam. கிருத்வா விதாய உஷாம் பலயுக்தாம் கிருத்வா கீதிருஷ பலயுக்தாம் அனிருத்த கடனா அனிருத்த சம்யோகா. சோ ஐ ஹவ் மேட் உஷா த ரெசிபியன்ட் ஆஃப் தட் கம்பேட்டபிலிட்டி அதிகத அபிரூபம். அபிரூபம் மீன்ஸ் சோ த மொமெண்ட் உஷா சா அனிருத்த இன் ஹர் ட்ரீம்ஸ் ஷீ தாட் இட் இஸ் அ யோக்ய வரஹா இதி தஸ்யாஹ மனசி அபவத். So that is Abhirupa, Abhirupa Lakshmi, that beauty, a beauty which is very compatible to her own beauty. Tadrisham phalam phalasya tadrisham phalam adigatam. So adigatam Abhirupa Lakshmi phalam yaya. What is that phalam? Which is aniruddha ghatana. Aniruddha samyogaha is that ghatana. She actually dreams of being in close quarters with Aniruddha. Okay, so தாதிருஷாம் அசுரராஜகன்யாம் விதாய ஏஷஹ அஹம் பிராப்தஹ அதுனா சாக்ஷாத் பிராப்தஹ. சோ அனிருத்தா ஹஸ் கம் இன் பர்சன் ஆஸ் சித்ரலேகா இஸ் டிராயிங் த ஃபார்ம். உஷா ஹஸ் ஷீ சேஸ் உஷா ஹஸ் ஆல்ரெடி என்ஜாய்ட் பீயிங் வித் மீ இன் ஹர் ட்ரீம்ஸ் அண்ட் ஐ எம் ஆல்சோ பார்ன் ஃப்ரம் பார்வதிஸ் ஃபேஸ் பிகாஸ் ஐ எம் மன்மதா சவதார. Even Sura, now here, Sura Sura Manoratha Duravarti, in that is the problem area here. Manorathanam Api Duravarti Iti Vaktavye Apishabdaha Nauktaha Atra. So Apishabda, at least in some manner, it has to be indicated, but it is not being said here. Atra Sura Suranam Api Manorathanam Api Duravarti Iti Artha Dvayam அவசியம் வக்தவியம். If you look at the வியாக்கியானம் I made a note of that because that explains it very beautifully. So அத்ர சுரா சுராணாமபி மனோரதானாமபி தூரவர்த்தி. So that அபி சப்த should be connected with both சுரா சுராணாம் and மனோரதானாம். That effect is lost here. So அஹம் மனோரதானாம் தூரவர்த்தி அஸ்மி. That is your first. Because you cannot see me first, and nobody can look at me. Indriya vishayaha na asmi bahirindriyaha asmi iti. That is na kevalam bahirindriyaha manasopi adrishyaha iti. So I cannot be attained even by manoratham tadrishaha aniruddhaha. Next, who is manoratha? Manushyanam manoratha? No, surasuranam api manorathaha. That impossibility also has to be indicated in this. None of this has the effect when all of that has come into the samasa. Samasa gatatvena atra vaktavya avashya vaktavya apishabdartha na uktah. That is why it is anabhihita vachyatva. Api is nipatam, it is not a vibhaktyartham. Whereas in the purva shloke, there you have purvasmin shloke, it is, what is that? The prathama vibhakti is not there. Apahritaha aham. Yadyapi aham apahritaha, that vibhakti nyunatvam is there. Apahritasya mama, it has already gone into the entire vakyam and the force is not there.
Oh, okay. So enak oriya irudhu. So modal shlokathla vandu prathama vibhaktili irundhaduna namalukku maybe that yadyapi oda artham vandirukku.
Yes, then it is adhyaharyam, correct.
But okay, so shashti vibhaktila potadnala we get distracted. Okay, okay. For Korea.
Correct. I was not very convinced about it. Sorry, if you think it is convincing enough, then I'm good. So if the Prathama Vibhakti was present, then Yadyapi can be Adhyaharyam. Since the Prathama Vibhakti is not there, we cannot understand that Yadyapi also. Okay. Now here in this shloka, it is nipata nyunatvam, which is api is a nipata shabdam, and that is present, and that in fact that is gone into the samasa. This is actually in the samasa gatam is also videya vimarsha dosham is also present here. Not all shlokas cannot be just an example for only one dosha. He is just highlighting that particular dosha here. He is highlighting the apishabda, which is a nipata nyunatvam, in samasagata nipata nyunatvam. That's all he is highlighting. But you cannot deny the fact that there is avimrishta vidayamsha dosha is also there in this because of that samasa. Okay. நெக்ஸ்ட் ஒன், த்வயி நிபத்தரதேஹி பிரியவாதினஹ பிரணயபங்க பராங்முக சேதசஹ கம் அபராதலவம் மம பஷ்யசி தியஜசி மானினி தாசஜனம் யதஹ. ஹே மானினி கோபினி, நாயிகா இஸ் பீங் அட்ரெஸ்ட் ஹியர், திஸ் இஸ் இன் விக்ரமோர்வசியம், வேர் விக்ரமா புரூரவஸ் லுக்ஸ் அட் த கிரி நதி, ஹி லுக்ஸ் அட் அ மவுண்டன் ரிவர் அண்ட் திங்ஸ் தட் இட் இஸ் ஊர்வசி, ஊர்வசி இது சம்பாவிய தாம் பிரதி வததி புரூரவா. சோ வாட் டஸ் ஹி சே, ஹி சேஸ் தி ரிவர் இஸ் நேச்சுரலி ஃப்ளோயிங். ஓகே, சோ இமேஜின் ஹி இஸ் செப்பரேட்டட் ஃப்ரம் ஊர்வசி ஹியர். He looks at the river and the river has ripples. He sees Urvashi's face there and he thinks she is frowning. Her forehead and her eyebrows are all crooked. It's like the ripples in the river resemble her forehead. So he addresses her as Manini, one who is very angry. So, and she is also flowing away from him. You should imagine that scene here. So if the river is flowing away from him, she says, why are you leaving me? He says, why are you leaving me and going? Dasajanam tyajasi. I am forever in you know, like a slave to you. I am attached to you. Why are you leaving me and going? Kimartham tyajasi tvam. What mistake did you see in me? Kam aparadha lavam mama pashyasi yataha dasajanam tyajasi. So what he explains his situation here, he says mama, but the everything else in the first line is an adjective to mama. It's all in shashti vibhakti. So twayi nibaddharate he, I am attached to you. Twayi nibaddharati, I always want to be with you, who is completely attached to you. Priyavadinaha, I don't speak harshly to you, I speak very sweetly. Priyavadinaha பிரணயபங்க பராங்முக சேதசா, நான் பிரியவாதி பவேத், பரந்து ஹி கேன் ஆல்சோ கோ அண்ட் ஹாவ் அ ரிலேஷன்ஷிப் வித் அனதர் பர்சன், பட் ஹி இஸ் நாட் லைக் தட், ஹி இஸ் என்டையர்லி டிவோட்டட் டு யூ. ஸோ நிபத்தரதே ஹே, ஹி ஆல்சோ வாண்ட்ஸ் டு என்ஜாய் வித் யூ, அண்ட் ஹி இஸ் அஃப்ரேட் ஆஃப் செப்பரேஷன். பிரணயபங்க, தட் தி பிரேக்கிங் ஆஃப் தட் ரிலேஷன்ஷிப், பிரணயம், ஹி இஸ் அஃப்ரேட் ஆஃப் தட். பராங்முக, ஹி டஸ் நாட் வாண்ட் தட். Parangmukha is you turns his face away from it. So Parangmukha chetasaha mama kam aparadhalavam pashyasi, what is that fault that you see, that you have left me and gone, that you are leaving me and going. Tyajasi dasajanam evam tyajasi. Now here the meaning actually atra aparadhasya lavam api. Now that lavam api should have been present. That is, api is the avashya vaktavya, avashya vaktavyaha. What happens is, if you don't use that api, aparadha lavam api, even a small aparadha, what is that, even a little bit of dosham that you have seen, that you are leaving me and going. அபராத லவம் ந பஷ்யசி கிந்து மகாந்தம் அபராதம் பஷ்யசி இதி ப்ராயஹ ப்ரதியேத. If that apishabda is not there, then you can take it as, no, kam aparadha lavam pashyasi. Maybe it is a small mistake that you're leaving me for, but there could be a bigger mistake that I have done. So it's not very clear there, right? There is actually a viruddha pratiti here. Whereas in the earlier one, vivakshitartha, so the anavita vachyam can give a result in two ways. One is vivakshitartha pratitihi na bhavet, athava viruddha pratitihi bhavet. So here, this is an example of viruddha pratiti. See, he says, prathame dushakata bijam, prathame abhimata pratitihi, antye yohotu viruddha pratitihi. So lavam api ityarthe aparadha lavam na pashyasi, kintu mahantam aparadham pashyasi, yataha pam mam tyajasi. That is the reasoning that he gives for the dosha. So, in this case, I can accept that there is a dosham in both these cases, but the first one, I am not too sure, but that's okay. Now let's go to the next dosham, is asthanastha padam. Asthanastha padam is Actually, the Karika mentions apadastha pada samasam that can be split into two, apadastha padam, apadastha samasam cha. Those are the two doshas. So the first dosha is apadastha padam. Here padam means sthanam. Padam can also mean shabdaha. So the first pada means sthanam. The second pada means padam or shabda. So apadastham, that's why we rephrase it and use the word asthanastha padam and asthanastha samasam because of the confusion with the word pada. There can be two meanings for that. Apadastham meaning asthanastham or asthane sthitam, ayogya sthane sthitam. The word is present in a place where it is not appropriate. Again, there are two possibilities. One is viruddha pratiti and vivakshita upayoga asambhavaha. Very similar to anabhihita vachyam. Let's go to the shlokam here. Priyena sangrathya vipaksha sannidhau upahitam vakshasi pivarastane srajam nakachit vichahau jalabilam vasantihi premni gunan avastushu. This is taken from Bharavi Kiratarjuniyam. अष्टमे सर्गे किरातार्जुनीये अष्टमे सर्गे जलक्रीडा वर्णने कस्याश्चित् नायिकायाः वर्णनम् इदम्. इन् द एय्थ् सर्ग सो अर्जुन गोस् एण्ड् पर्फार्म्स् तपस् इन् आर्डर् टु प्लीस् शिव एण्ड् देन् इन्द्र सेण्ड्स् अप्सरस् स्त्री टु destroy his tapas, destroy his concentration. And one sarga is a complete description of different krida that they perform in front of him in order to distract his attention. So here one of the girls, that is one of the apsarastri, the celestial damsels, as you say, priyena sangratya, she is wearing a mala. She's also taking a bath in the, because it's a jalakrida, she has a srak, a mala on her neck. And actually that mala has been done by the priya. Priyena sangratya vipaksha sannidhau pivarastane vakshasi upahitam jalavilam srajam kachit na vijahau. That is your Anvaya here. Let's not look at the dosham, so we'll look at this first. So kachit apsarastri. So kachit malam srajam jalavilam srajam na vijahau. She did not let go of the garland which was jala avilam, which was dirtied by the water. Generally, if you put the flower and immerse inside for a bath, with a flower garland, it will become soggy and it will not look nice and fresh. So jalavilam srajam kachit na jahau. Some apsarastri, one of the people who were playing there, did not let go of the garland even though it was dirtied by the water. And how is that garland? The rest are all adjectives to it. Priyena sangratya, it's only one adjective actually, upahitam, it has been placed on her chest. So priyena sangratya, a nayaka by her lover, it was made by her lover. Vipaksha sannidhau, and in front of the other wives, other ladies, he had placed it on her chest. Upahitam vakshasi, on her chest, which is pivarastane vakshasi. The adjective for vakshasi is pivarastana, which had lofty breasts. So to show that Shringara rasam, the priya had of his own accord, with his own hands, he had made that garland, and in front of other wives, to show his favorite, he put the flowers in such a manner that it was touching her breast. So that is why she did not want to remove that garland at all. Kachit na vijahau. So the shlokam is fine. The placement of the words in the shloka, if you look at it, srajam na kachid vijahau jala avilam vasantihi premni gunan avastushu. I forgot the last part, which is the arthandranyasa. Premni குணாஹ பிரேம்ணி வசந்தி நது வஸ்துஷோ வசந்தி. குணாஹ குட் குவாலிட்டிஸ் எக்ஸிஸ்ட் ஒன்லி இன் பிரேமா அண்ட் நாட் இன் objects. So qualities here means attraction or greatness. So greatness is present in love and not in vastu. So the object might be really dirty and really cheap object, but still it is the sentiment that goes with that is not, that is the one that matters, right? It may be a very small trinket, but if it is being given with some love, then you take it and you give more value to it. That is the Arthantrinyasam he gives and the value that he gives from this shloka. Here, atra kachit na vijahau iti vachyam, kintu na kachit vijahau iti uktam. What is the problem if you place in Sanskritam? The syntax can be however. It cannot. Here, the way he has placed it in the kavyam, in the shlokam, it says, srajam na kachit vijahau apitu sarvaha vijakhruhu. That is the viruddha pratiti that comes. See, not only one person let go of that garland, everybody let go of that garland. So he put that garland to everybody. Upahitam srajam sarve api vijakhruhu. Which means it gives us the pratiti that they were not interested in whatever the lover was giving to them. The lover gave, the Priya gave them, the Nayaka gave the Nayikas, the Apsarastri, a garland, and they, all of them, they let go of the garlands that was put on them by their Priya. That is a meaning that we will get. Na kachit vijahau kintu sarvaha. Na ekam kintu sarvam. That is how we take it as if that nan comes in front of the samya. Generally, it is a rule that the nanya should go with the kriyapadam, and if it goes with the kriyapadam, then it gives the proper meaning. In shloka, if the kavi has put it like this, then it could give a viruddha pratiti. We have to avoid that. Here it is an ayogya sthana, where it is not an appropriate sthanam for the padam na to be. Okay. Asthanastha padam. Next is also next is about not viruddha pratiti, but what is that? Vivakshita upayoga asambhavat. As such, whatever is relevant, what is the meaning that the poet wishes to convey is not being conveyed here. Because the padam is placed at a different position. Lagna keli kacha graha slatha jata lambena nidrantare mudrankaha siti kandharendu shakalena antah kapolasthalam parvatya nakha lakshma shankita sakhi narmasmita khritaya pronmrishtaha karapallavena kutila tamra chavihi patu vaha. Parvatyaha mudrankaha vaha patu. The main sentence is that where let Parvati's mudra ankaha, the mark that is there on her cheeks, let it protect you. Now, what is this mark? He gives the reason, and it's like one small story here. The day before, Parvati has spent the night with Shiva, and because of the different keli, rati keli that has happened between Parvati and Shiva, the kachagraham, the jata of Shiva was loosened, and the chandra shakalam, you know, that small the crescent moon that is there on his head fell down, and during the night it must have made an impression on her cheeks. She was sleeping on her side, and she was sleeping in close quarters, so she was sleeping very near to Shiva. She was lying down, and his hair was very loose, shithilam. So, and from that, the moon had come out and she was sleeping. The moon had somehow come in contact with her cheeks. So in the morning, there is a small mark on her cheek, which is crescent-like. The Sakhi who looks at her, she thinks, she actually teases her by saying it is a nakha kshatam. It is Shiva's nail marks. So, Nakha Lakshma Shankita Sakhi Narmasmita Khritaya. So, the moment she the Sakhi teases Parvati, she tries to rub it, pronmrishtaha. Because she tries to rub it, it becomes kutila adamra chavihi. It is already red. So when you sleep, you know, sometimes when you wear bangles and sleep with your hand like this, there will be an impression of that bangle on your cheeks. Huh? It's like that. Here, the moment the Sakhi teases her, she tries to rub it. And the more you rub, the red, it will become even more reddish, right? Because you're agitating that blood vessels there and it gives out a color more. So, kutila adamra chavihi. It is adamra, it is a reddish luster that comes out of that mark. Tadrishaha mudrankaha vaha patu. So, let's look at the meaning. Keli kachagraha shlatha jata lambena. It is just hanging to that jata, which is shlatha, loosened because of the Keli Kachagraha. During the Keli, Rati Keli time, she had caught his hair and that is why it was loosened and from there it was hanging. What is that? Shiti Kandhara Shivasya. Shiti Kandharaha, Shiti is peacock, Kandhara is neck or shoulder. So he has a Neelakantaha Ityartha. So Shiti Kandharasya Indushakalena, by that small crescent moon that is there. Antah kapolasthalam lagnaha. So it is sticking to that antah kapola, right? Kapola antare or on the cheeks while she was sleeping, nidrantare, during sleep, on her cheeks it was lagnaha. It had gotten associated with her cheeks while sleeping. So in the morning what happened? Kutila atambra chavihi. Now it is already red in color. And that nakha lakshmi, because it is red in color. See, not because it is just there is a mark, but it is already red in color. Her skin is very soft. Sukumaratvata, immediately that mark is become very pinkish. So because it is pinkish, she thinks it is nakha lakshma. That is why it makes sense that the kutila adambra chavihi should be before nakha lakshma. To give the idea, to give the doubt that it is a nakhakshata. So Sakhi, who thought it was nakha lakshma shankita Sakhi, narma smita hritaya. Smita is laughter, narma smita is teasing laughter. Hritaya, because of that teasing laughter from her Sakhi, she was ashamed. Hritaya, she was very shy. Pronmrishtaha, that which was rubbed off. Parvatyaha mudrankaha, let that mudranka vaha path. Now here, kutila yuktam atamra chavitvam sakishanka hetu. So kutila atamra chavi should occur before nakalakshma shankita. Parvatya nakalakshma shankita saki narmasmita hritaya pronmrishtaha karapallavena kutila atamra chavihi patubaha. It is actually the mudranka that should protect us. And that kutila atamra chavi should come before nakalakshma so that we understand the reason for nakalakshma. Nakakshatam also because of that blood, right? We need that red color to give the idea of nakakshata. So hetu, the hetu here is the why there is a vivakshita pratitihi na jayate. Vivakshita upayoga asambhavaha means whatever is being intended by the poet has not been used properly in this shloka. The intention is for us to know that the hetu is kutila atambra chavihi, the rakta chavi is the hetu. And the hetuman or the sadhyam, that which is the result of that, is the nakhalakshma shanka, nakhakshata shanka. So hetu and hetuman should be near to each other for us to immediately get an understanding of the meaning. It takes a longer time and pratiti vilambhat rasa pratiti rapi vilambena jayate iti dosha. This is apadastha padam. Next one is apadastha samasam. Adhyapi stanashaila durga vishame simantini nam hridi sthatum vanchati manayesha dhigiti krodhadiva alohitaha புரோத்யத் தூரதர பிரசாரித கரஹா கர்ஷத்யசௌ தக்ஷணாத் புல்லத் கைரவ கோஷ நிஸ்ஸரத் அலி ஸ்ரேணி கிருபாணம் சசி. இன் திஸ் ஸ்லோக தி மெயின் இஸ் ஏஷஹ மானஹா அத்யாபி சீமந்தினீனாம் ஹிருதி ஸ்தாதும் வாஞ்சதி இதி க்ரோதாத் இவ சசி ஆலோஹிதஹ புரோத்யத் பிரசாரித கரஹ கிருபாணம் கர்ஷதி. மெயின் சென்டென்ஸ் ஹியர் இஸ் சசி கிருபாணம் கர்ஷதி. சசி சந்திர அசௌ சசி திஸ் சந்திர ஹூ இஸ் தேர் கிருபாணம் கர்ஷதி ஹி இஸ் டேக்கிங் அவுட் ஹிஸ் ஸ்வோர்ட். இஃப் சம்வன் இஸ் டேக்கிங் அவுட் தி ஸ்வோர்ட் ஃப்ரம் த கோஷ ஃப்ரம் இட்ஸ் ஐ டோன்ட் நோ தி மீனிங் கோஷம் இட்ஸ் கவர். If someone is taking out the sword from the kosha, it means he is going for a fight or a war. Who is he going to fight against? He is going to fight against the mana, which is the kopaha that is there in simantininam hrudi sthitaha kopaha saeva shatruhu atra. He says yeshaha manaha, this kopam that is there in the minds of a nayaka. Anayika is actually feeling very angry towards her. She has had a pranaya kalaham with her nayaka, so she is feeling angry. Her mind is filled with anger. Now the moment the chandra rises, you have to feel very happy about it and you want to be with your beloved. So the kopam has to go away from the minds of the ladies. Then only they can enjoy the beautiful moonlit night. For that, this Shashi, the Chandra, he says that this Manaha is like a Pratinayaka here. That imagery is there. So Pratinayakaha Yatha, or he wants to be in the minds of the ladies, whereas this Kopaha is there in the minds of the ladies. So it is like a Pratinayaka or a Shatha, Dhurta, who is present in the minds of the people, in the minds of the ladies, and he is trying to yuddham kartum gacchati iva, icchati iva. So baddha vairaha iva, saha shashi, kripanam uddharati. Because it is a villain who is there with the ladies, and he is like the Nayaka, Shashi is like the Nayaka, Mana is like the Shatha, who is with the Nayika. So he has to win over that manaha. So what is the reasoning? He says, yeshaha manaha stana shaila durga vishame. Stana shaila durga vishame. Hridi, the hridayam of simantini, of the ladies, have this the lofty breasts, and it is vishame. It is also up and down in that hridi. Adhyapi sthatum icchati yeshaha manaha. It wants to be there. Iti krodhat iva, as if he is angry. Utreksha. Ati lohitaha, alohitaha is reddish in color. The rising moon or the set, yeah, rising moon is more reddish because of the rays of the setting sun. So alohitaha asau shashi, prodhyat duratara prasarita karaha. He takes out his sword. Now what is this sword here that the moon is taking out? Pullat kairava கோஷ நிஸ்ஸரத் அலி ஸ்ரேணி புல்லத் கைரவம். த கைரவா இஸ் லிலி ஃப்ளவர் விச் ப்ளூம்ஸ் டியூரிங் த நைட் அண்ட் தட் இஸ் த கோஷம். தி இன்டீரியர் ஆஃப் தட் இஸ் லைக் த கோஷம். த ப்ளூமிங் லிலி இஸ் லைக் த கோஷம் அண்ட் தி அலி ஸ்ரேணி கிருபாணம். த அஸ் சூன் இஸ் த லிலி ஃப்ளவர் ப்ளூம்ஸ் தெர் இஸ் அ ஸ்டார்ம் ஆஃப் பீஸ் தட் கம்ஸ் இன் அ ஸ்ட்ரெயிட் லைன் into the lily flower to enjoy the madhu. So that is like a sword. So sword is actually not white or golden in color. It is actually black in color because of the metal. So this row of bees is like the sword. So kosha nissarat ali shreni kripanam saha karshati. It's the poet is fancying that Shashi is pulling out the sword. Now what is the problem? Atra kruddhasya uktau samasaha na kritaha. Apadastha samasam is your problem. So asthanastha samasam. When someone is angry, the words have to come out in a flow, and there should be the angry words should have more samasa than the description of the moon. So சந்திரஸ்ய உக்திஹி அத்யாபி டு திக் யூனோ ஏஷஹ திக் இதி அண்டில் தட் தேர் ஷுட் பி ரௌத்ர ரசம் தட் ஷுட் பி ரிவீல்டு தேர் வெரஸ் when you are describing the nature of how the lotus or the lily is bloomed and how the bees are all present, how the moon is present, when you are describing the nature, it does not, there is no necessity for dirgha samasatva. You need the dirgha samasa in the krodha yukta ukti natu varnane apekshitah. Okay, that is the problem here. So the samasa is placed in an inappropriate place. Apadastha asthane sthitam samasam, that is the dosham here. Okay, we will stop with this for today. I'll continue with the next one next class.